Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. In today's video, we are going to be taking a look at the Lime Life Planner. Okay, so let's jump right in. What I have today to share with you all is a 7x9 Lime Life Planner. I purchased this a few weeks ago, so it finally arrived this past week. So it took about 2.5, 3 weeks to get here, but I'm kind of excited to take a look at this planner, mainly because this cover is probably one of my favorites that I've ever had on any planner, and I hope that there's a way that if this planner does not work for me, that I can take this cover with me because I absolutely love it. All right, so let's jump right in. This is a 7x9 weekly planner. Of course, it comes with the monthly view as well. I did pay $55 for this particular planner. There are some additional add-ons that you can get that of course come at an additional cost, like checklists, meal planning, budgeting, an add-on folder, a plastic folder, and so on and so forth. Even notes pages, both lined and dot grid, which is nice. It does have a very nice substantial metal coil. This is very, very strong, typical of a spiral bound planner, so you won't be disappointed in that. I do believe they also have rose gold as an option, which of course you guys know I would never in a million years pick a rose gold coil. Platinum or gold is my preference. I would have even taken a black coil, but I don't remember seeing black as an option on their website. All right, let's open this up. So the cover that I have is called the Kate. They have a lot of different cover options and you can get them personalized with your name or whatever phrase, quote, saying, anything that you want on them, as long as it fits, obviously. So when you open it up, you'll see the inside cover has that same design carried throughout the entire inside cover. I can't remember, I honestly don't remember adding this clear folder insert thing. What do you call this thing? But I'm glad that it's here. I'm loving seeing that this is an option. This is also an option over at Plum Paper, which is very, very nice. I like these kind of folders a lot. So it came with a little sticker that says nothing worth having comes easy. I think that's pretty cute. And then a little, hey, thanks for your first order, because this was indeed my first order with Lime Life. And I guess a little note from the team over there. So that's really nice. What I love is the back of this. Oh my God. I think if anything, excited about this. It matches the cover, which is just, you guys know I'm already in love with that, but I'm gonna put this up in my office without a doubt. Whether I use this planner or not, this cover is coming with me, this card is coming with me. That's really all that I need. Okay, so you have that clear folder insert thing right there. You have the title page, this is Lime Life Planners. You will never find time for anything. If you want time, you must make it. That was a little hard to read in that font, but that's okay. And then it has all of their socials where you can find them. Has a little bit more information down at the bottom where it says they are assembled in Oxford, Pennsylvania. And the paper is and I pulled this right off of the website because I honestly couldn't tell when I was touching the paper. It is smooth. They describe it on their website as an ultra smooth, bright white, 80-pound paper that is archival and acid free. So good to know. All right, so starting off, you have some special dates over here on the left, and it includes dates for 2020 and 2021. I do love the amount of holidays that they have included in here. I'm not necessarily someone that needs the holidays in my planner because a lot of these I might not celebrate myself, but they are nice to have because they could affect your work life, for example. Then you have a year at a glance with the calendars laid out for you. For some reason though, I was like, why is there not a 2020? I thought that that was odd. We're in 2020, I'd like a 2020 year at a glance, but for some reason I have a 2021 and a 2022. Let's go to the back and see. I just find that kind of, yeah, there's no year at a glance for 2020 at all in this planner. I don't exactly understand that. Maybe it was a mistake, I don't know. But I would have really liked some 2020 year at a glance because I use that for school stuff, work stuff, paydays, all that fun stuff. Then you have this next section that is for habit tracking. I found this also interesting as well. It looks like they're giving you like 66 days to start some new habits. It gives you some tips right there. Honestly, I didn't go too much in depth to this because this isn't really something that I would use if I was using this planner. I prefer daily and weekly habits, maybe even monthly, but the 66-day thing, that's pretty interesting. But I guess it's a habit-forming system, which is pretty cool. Then you have your accounts, passwords, and logins. Again, something I wouldn't necessarily keep in my planner because if I lost this and it had all of my login information, that would be just a little bit disastrous. Okay. And then you have another page, again, for the same thing. So that's front and back on there. Then you have I guess this is going to be your year at a glance. I would have preferred to have the other version for 2020 instead of this. But I guess if you prefer having this where you can write out what it is that's going on that day, then that's fine too. I guess I'm just more used to this other layout where I could use color coding and mark things. So I guess either version would work. I do have, this is my preference though, for sure. Okay, and that goes all the way from January through, so it's on four pages because you get the entire year. All right, so here we go. We're jumping into the first month. Mine does start for the month of August 2020. I also found this to be interesting. The cover is like a cardstock, but it is not coded at all. The only part of this divider that is coded is the tab itself. It is very, very well laminated, but I was kind of shocked that this wasn't more of a coded type of paper because there's nothing on the back of the divider here. So it would have been nice to have it coded. I'm not saying that it's not durable, it just, you know, I would have liked to have seen something, I don't know, something else. I'm glad that it's plain. I am very glad that it's plain. I'll say that. So when you jump right in, you get a lined notes page with that same decorative dot pattern, but in a gray color. One of the things that I did love on the Lime Life website was that you can actually choose if you want your layout to be neutral or colorful. So this is the first time I'm seeing a planner like this that truly does give you all the other parts colorful to include your tabs, but lets you choose the guts to be neutral, which is what I was super, super excited about and why I ordered this planner. So another thing that I did love and I got to choose, which was amazing, is that in your month view, you can choose whether you want a Sunday or a Monday start. And of course, I chose a Monday start. In my mind, that just makes all the sense in the world. If your weeks start on a Monday, why don't your months start on a Monday? I think it makes planning easier overall. You do get a column over here for all of your notes and lists for the month. Up at the top, you can see you have the month and the year, and of course, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and so on all the way through Sunday. I love that it's neutral. I'm a little concerned about all the busyness up here, but if you don't use kits or anything like that, this is about as neutral as you're going to get in a planner that is also colorful in all the other areas. So I'm not totally mad at it. Now here comes the week. This is where I'm a little bit concerned. So I chose layout A, which is basically a vertical with lines, but it's also kind of broken up into three sections. My concern here is the header part, but I don't want to talk about that just yet. Over here on the left-hand side, you'll see there's a lot going on here. It has the month and the year up here on the upper left. Then you also have a month view, and it's already highlighted for you. And then there's the dots again. But the dots are far more profound than they looked on the website, at least for me. This is so busy and distracting, it's a little bit much. I would have loved had they just left the dots off of this page altogether. It's not so bad on the month page. That part is, it's like, okay, it's up there, it's out of the way. It's not on a space that I'm writing on. But over here on this column, no, absolutely not. Another concern that I do have is, like I said, the headers. There's just all of this real estate up here that I feel like it's a little bit misused and you don't notice it until you have it in person. So it would have been nice if these date numbers were over here just on the left and then moved everything up. Then I would have loved to still have the box there. It also makes it really difficult if you're using any type of date covers. So just to show you what I mean, I'm going to grab a date header or a header, a strip, whatever you want to call these things. I actually already took it out earlier to see if it was even going to work, and it was just not really. It can cover that part, but then you still have the numbers to cover. You could cover it with washi below or do the dates here and cover it with washi above, but you're going to have to use two things just to cover up that stuff right there. The other great thing is with the Christian Design kits, you can get the option to have this thicker washi strip here. And that could solve the problem, but you would be doing this every single week if these dates bothered you. They really don't bother me all that much, but I love kits. So you could easily cover it up like so. That's how much space it takes up. You need quite a bit to cover it up if you wanted to. All right, let's get this off of there because I fully intend on using this kit at another time and I am not wasting my stickers. All right, so let's get that out of the way. So like I said, you get the vertical lines right here. The columns do appear to be the 1.5 inch standard size. Let me see if I can find another sticker and see if that is actually the case. I hadn't gone this far into trying things out to see if they actually worked like that. Okay, so they do fit. That's just a typical half box. It fits with no problem at all. And I'm gonna grab my sticker before I forget it in this planner and then I get mad at myself and hopefully it comes off. This is smooth paper. I've not had any problems with smooth paper and Christian Design stickers before. So that's good. Okay, so you have a little bit of space down at the bottom for like meals or whatever you want to do. I would probably just put my weather up here across the top and then just go about my day here. It does feel like you get a smaller space in the actual column, but you could actually just keep extending it all the way down, maybe put a strip of washi here if you wanted to. You could get really creative with this layout. There's also these sort of like black lines across the bottom. I think it's just there to be decorative. Again, if you're not really using a lot of stickers, none of this might bother you. It's not a huge bother to me, but I don't really know why they're there. I feel like that could have been, you know, done without and it would have been just fine. So there are your weeks. And then at the end of the month, let's see if you get another notes page. Yes, you get another notes page. I'm assuming it corresponds with this month. It could be the other way around and be for the month prior. But let me show you the colors of each month. Here is September. Then there is October, November, December, January. Again, I love that the colors are just on the dividers. I think that's really cool. It's something that I've always wanted in a planner, so I really do like it. I think it's kind of different to see orange for the month of April. May is yellow. It is not peach. Praise the planner gods. Thank you for that, Lime Life. I appreciate it because I'm really tired of seeing May be peach. All right, there's June and July. And it does come with some notes pages in the back. Again, I need to try and find my receipt in my emails to see if I added this on. I thought the notes pages already came with it, but what I do like is that this is what their dot grid looks like. It's actually, the dot grid is pretty like in your face. It's really hard to see through the camera, but the dots, they are there. Oh my gosh. I really do like it though. You guys know I love dot grid, so I think it's great. And there's about 20 or 30 pages of just dot grid, nothing else, and it's going to be a lot of great space for you to use and plan out throughout the year. And then there is the back of the cake cover, and you can see the inside of the back cake cover there. The covers are not removable, so that's something to think about, but you could easily snip them off if you wanted to. I don't know if you can order covers by themselves. I need to double check that on the website. One of the things that I like is the variety of layouts for this planner. So in this 7x9 size, this is only one of 8 layouts. 8. That is huge. So there's a little bit of something for everyone, and you can get them in colorful or neutral, which is just amazing. And like I said, there's a lot of add-ons. I think that that is definitely a big plus for this planner. Again, I love the cover options, and I like that you can have a true neutral mixed in with the colorful tabs. Now, there are cons for me in this planner that I just don't like these things, and of course, it's my own personal preference. There's just the dots. There's just too many of those. I need a little less dots. I am concerned about how kits will work. I realize that just because you have a kit doesn't necessarily mean you're using date covers, but I'm a fan of date covers. So for me personally, it is a concern. Now, one of the things that shocked me was the shipping of this planner. So what I mean is the way it was shipped. So I got the notification that my planner had arrived. I was so excited, looked out on my porch. It wasn't there. It wasn't there because it was in my mailbox. And I have a very standard size mailbox. It was actually packaged up in a USPS bubble mailer and shoved into my mailbox. So I was a little bit shocked that it didn't at least come in a super basic box. Some of my tabs got a little bit damaged from being shoved into the mailbox, but again, personal preference, if you're gonna spend this kind of money on a planner, I would just hope that it would get packaged up a little bit better. But again, that's just my own personal preference. I was really shocked that it came in a bubble mailer. That's just my opinion. All right, so there is that for my overall thoughts on everything. I do want to try out some pens. So I grabbed a few ones that are commonly used and I'm just gonna go ahead and try them out and just see how they smudge on the paper and then come back and show you guys how they shadow or ghost or bleed or anything like that. Alright, so here are all of the pens that I tried. I'm honestly shocked that the tool smudged the way that it did on the end, but everything else seemed to do really, really well on this paper. Let's go ahead and check out the back side and see how it looks. Alright, so really the only thing that I see shadowing, and I don't know if you guys will be able to see it, was the Zebra Click Art, which is a porous tip type of marker, left a little bit of shadowing right there, but there really is no bleed through on this paper, which is very, very nice. Alright, so that is everything for my review of the Lime Life Planner. If you guys have any questions at all, please feel free to ask down below in the comments. I hope that you guys have found this review helpful and maybe helped you make a decision in your planner choices moving forward. If you like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe if you haven't already. And if you're already subscribed, make sure you click that notification bell so that you know when my videos are posted here on YouTube. As always, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video.